The 16 days of activism against gender-based violence on women and girls have entered day 10 with calls for all stakeholders to participate in creating a safe environment for women. Speaking at a symposium of women rights activists organized at Parliament today, Jennifer Aguti Ajij, the executive director of National Association of Women's Organizations in Uganda, feared that gender-based violence cases have remained on a rampage despite several laws made by the government to curb the vice.
The prevalence of gender-based violence remains high with alarming statistics. The domestic violence report by Uganda Police, this one was released on the 25th of February 2023. They reported increase in cases of gender-based violence from 17,553, imagine in thousands, to 17,698. And I know you will all agree with me that the statistics for 2023 will not be any better. If anything, it will even be higher.
In this regard, legislators and civil society organizations have urged the government to scale up gender-based violence shelters in all sub-regions to provide rescue to vulnerable victims of gender-related violence.
You can't go to report your father, your uncle, and go back to the same home where your father or uncle or that person that has violated your right is. So this is why it is important for us to ensure that government invests in these shelters, safe places where those victims of violence can actually be for the meantime as they wait to get justice.
The chairperson of the Uganda Women Parliamentary Association, Sarah Opendi, demanded for tightening laws and punishments, including one to legalize castration of defilers.
The only way is to cut off that dangerous tool. I think that call should remain. We need to cut off so that maybe when they cut off these things from these defilers, maybe others will learn a lesson, because that is a harsh punishment.
The proposal was endorsed by human rights defender Miriam Matembe, who recommended for castration as punishment for those convicted of aggravated development and gave justification for her radical position.
It's a penalty for what they call death penalty. And they give it to people who kill others. Why do you complain about mere castration, which is not even death?
Matembe reasoned that even though the Holy Bible tolerates such penalties, quoting Matthew chapter 5 verse 30, which provides that it is better for someone to lose one part of their body than for the whole body to be thrown into hell.
Not right to say that any potentially dangerous instrument should be taken away. I don't see, and you know, the moment I said this and the men rose up against me, that's when I knew that for sure many men are potential rapists.
According to the police's annual crime report of 2022, a total of 12,580 cases of defilement were reported to police in 2022, of which 3,620 cases were aggravated defilement. A total of 4,843 suspects of defilement were arrested and charged to court, out of whom 206 were convicted, 8 were discharged, while 4,502 were still awaiting trial. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News in Parliament.